The word of God is alive and powerful, sharper than any two-edged sword, piercing even to the dividing asunder of the soul and the spirit and the joints and the marrow. And it is a critic of thoughts and intents of the heart. All scripture is God-breathed and is profitable for doctrine, for reproof, for correction, for instruction in righteousness, that the man of God might be mature, thoroughly furnished unto all good works. Study to show thyself approved unto God, a workman that needeth not to be ashamed, rightly dividing the word of truth, or accurately handling the word of truth. Dear brethren, many lessons to be learned from Ephesians 4:12. At the same time, in comparison to the greatest verse ever written, to the Romans chapter 6, verses 1 and 7. Chapter 6, chapter 1, verses 7. The great verse, what we can learn from Romans 1:7, is that your faith is, and your belief has been known to the entire system or to the entire world. That was the great realm of thinking for the Romanism that could ever exist that time. But later on, they went on to prove the popery being the greatest evil that could be there. But when Apostle Paul was writing to the Romans and telling to them, he had a different intention. His intention was very clear, to tell how they have to be now not the slaves of sin, not the slaves of unrighteousness, but now they have to turn out to become the slaves of righteousness. Because for by one man sin entered into the world, and it is no longer that one man that it is going to be present to this world, but the new man after Christ that we need to rule. But this man, they have failed. Why this new man have to be ruled? So that now this new man can teach them the real importance of the doctrine. This new man can make them and train them up to the purpose of which Lord has chosen them and kept. Then this new man, which has to cause them to think as per the Ephesians 4:12 and 13, till Lord could come to the perfection in the knowledge of truth, everyone could work to the edification body of the soul, so that this body of the church, they could be really manifested. But ultimately, they have failed. Today, are we following the same footsteps? Today, are we looking upon the same standards? Dear brethren, it is of a very great lesson of such how the way this man, they reacted not to listen to the words of Christ our Lord, who said, I am the bread of the life, and anyone can eat, they will have eternal life. But they said, they fought themselves to think and could ask, how can we eat this man's flesh? That's what, dear brethren, the natural mind thinks, not into the realm of spiritual allegory. Many of the people have failed, and this is the result of today's Christendom. Today, as such, we have to take some of the things pertaining to the figure of speeches and some of the things pertaining to the word of the Lord, but we are not. We are interested only in those that could only tell to our mind, this could be true and that could be true. But we are not really interested in the word of the Lord, and that's what it is happening today in our pulpits. Dear brethren, think over this. If once upon a time Rome was being used to know about its faith towards the entire world, and we can know what are the lessons written till to the point of 8th chapter of Rome, and furthermore, we can continue to the reality of practical principles, giving this body as a living sacrifice unto our Lord in Romans 12, and what else can we tell about the mystery doctrine of the conclusion in Romans chapter 16, verses 25-27. But this man, what happened? They never understood. They never thought. And now the popery, which has been reigning, has really caused great myths and mythology in the pulpits. Think over these issues, dear brethren, as we shall continue in the next tape. Father, we are grateful for the privilege that was given to fellowship through the word. We pray that Lord God, the Holy Spirit, will enlighten us on these things and make it a source of blessing and challenge, sovereign Lord. For we ask it in Christ's name, Father. Amen.